Hey Capricorn, this is Sandy Couture, and I am here doing the astrological tarot reading for the sign of Capricorn for the month of July 2020. Right now, Capricorn, we have a lot of astrological information going on out there that's affecting all of us. We have quite a number of planets in retrograde. When that happens, it's kind of a time for review, a time for slowing down, a time for taking a look internally, but not only internally, making sure that if you're starting a new project, you have all the information, you know all the information before moving forward, not being impetuous. That's kind of hard right now for all of us, though, because Mars, the planet of action, the planet of movement, the planet of war and anger, has just moved into Aries, which is also Mars rules Aries. Aries is about new beginnings, starting things, jumping in, moving forward. But the worst thing we can do right now is to be impetuous with all of the retrogrades that are going on. So it is time for us to slow down, take a look within, and take a measure of where we are and where we're going for Capricorns. There have been a lot of eclipses on the Capricorn Cancer axis. So a Capricorn sun, if you have a Capricorn sun, you would have definitely felt all of the energies from the most recent eclipses. And there's another one coming up July 5th, which is a prenumbral eclipse, which means only a small portion of the moon will be eclipsed. And that kind of gives you maybe a glimpse into your unconscious, or an unconscious thought will burst through into your viewing. So just be kind of watching for that. There's also going to be a new moon in Cancer, I believe, on the 20th of or the 18th of July. New moons are about new beginnings. So this is a month for you, Capricorn, to kind of take a look at where you are and what's going on for you and where you want to see yourself maybe in a year from now. And excuse me, using all of your wonderful gifts to get there. So the first card that I pulled for you is the Knight of Pentacles. The Knight of Pentacles is shown differently in some different cards. But the thing about this knight is that he's kind of overextended himself. He's either in love with the chase or in love with the thrill, so he doesn't take time to process everything that's happening to him. And sometimes Capricorns can be very tenacious and want to move forward at all costs and get her done, get the job done, but that's not always the best scenario. So with this being representing where you are right now, my suggestion is to slow down and regroup, do some meditating. Take a look at where it is you're overextending yourself, or if you're truly enthusiastic about a new project, or it's just your old way of operating. The challenge card, challenge or surprise card, is the King of Cups. Now, the King of Cups represents spirit within this suit, and kings are, of course, the highest and the masculine. King has reached a high level of emotional development. But the one challenge to watch out for, Capricorn, is don't feel that you're aloof from everybody, because you have developed this sense of emotional maturity that you can absolutely be very articulate about what you're feeling, but also you have a really good sense of how other people are feeling, and you have an ability to help them articulate it and to move through it. But don't put yourself aloof or think that you're not really better, but you know, in a different category than them, because the most important thing you can do is to offer your gifts in earnest. The Process card is to use balance in all things. The Two of Pentacles, this is about money too, you know, pentacles are about money and well-being, is to just be in balance. But this card is more about balancing the yin and the yang, your emotions and your intellect. The water behind him, you know, represents emotions, and he's got a green cloak on, but blue over his throat chakra, so he obviously can communicate well. But it's all about balance. The process for you this month is to balance your male and female, balance your yin and yang. Don't rush off or become tenacious about something without actually taking into account all of the facets of where you're going. Ooh. And the outcome card is the Tower card. Change is happening. The truth is, the Tower card is not about death or things blowing up, but it is about change. And I think for anyone who has a Capricorn sun, with all of the astrological influences that have been happening over the last year, you can't help but have changed. If you have not changed, you're living an unconscious life, and maybe it's time for you to take a look within to see where it is you may want to improve your internal perceptions of life or what's happening for you. So you maybe overextend yourself and get too caught up in having to get it done. You have a gift for understanding the emotions of people around you and your own and are very articulate about it. Just don't set yourself aloof from others. Balance your male and female aspects, your emotions and your intellect. Don't get into your head. And embrace the change. Embrace the new beginning, because there is certainly going to be one for you. Hopefully that was helpful for you Capricorns out there. And thank you for listening. Have a wonderful month. Bye now.